This is a Silk exclusive.
Welcome to another episode of Words, Music, Dance. I'm your host, as always, Paulie the Bull, no relation to Gravano. Today I got a special guest, first time guest on the show, new to the show, you know, rookie right here, family, friend, big homie, brother,
long time,
all that good stuff, my niece's daddy. You don't put all the business out there.
That's what it is.
You know what I mean? It's the homie Jay, aka Jovan, aka Javon, all that good stuff.
It's a lot of that.
Big Silky.
For a little while.
But family, what's going on, sir?
What's going on, man?
Alrighty. Shout out to all the listeners on all the podcast apps and all that good stuff. Shout out to all the viewers on YouTube. You are appreciated. You know what I mean? And Jay, shout out to you coming through. Finally getting you on here.
I mean, I'm old.
Okay. So that's the excuse you're going with?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm old, I'm washed up.
Okay.
But I'm here now.
But you're here now. That's what it's all about. Anybody you wanna say shout out to?
Everybody.
Shout out to everybody?
Yeah, we're just gonna go with everybody.
Shout out to everybody.
If you feel left out, I still love you.
Oh, there you go. I might use that. If you feel left out, I still love you. There you go. I like that. But what's new with you? What's going on in the world these days, man?
Not a lot. I mean, again,
Older wash. Okay.
Like, life is a struggle.
We about to get deep.
You know, I mean, everything's good, though. I'm happy.
Right.
Doing my thing.
Wait, so like, we need to turn it to a therapy session? Like, do we need to get on the couch and lay down and like, talk
but
about it?
The thing is, the more each day I realize why our parents did and said the things that they said. Because you get on a train, you get on a bus, and you look at kids, or you look at even adults, you're like, what the? So, I mean, I'm officially old.
Right.
Officially old.
Okay, I got you. We there now.
Yeah.
Shout out to our parents.
Yeah.
Hi, Mom. How everybody doing? All the family. Y'all all down together, actually. You're down in the show. So, you know, shout out to all y'all. I'll be seeing y'all next month. You going down anytime soon?
I'm trying to... I want to get down there, but Christmas, gifts, funding.
I got you.
Then, you know, right behind it, birthdays. Birthdays.
I got you.
Anniversaries. Pockets dry.
I feel you.
But, yeah, we're going to get out there.
No doubt. Well, like I said, everybody all in the same place, so, you know, it's just one trip. That's why I like it. I'll be down there to see them. And I am your gift, by the way. You know, y'all watching, I ain't buying nothing. You know, I am the gift.
Bringing the gift of
God. That's me. You know, hey, I put a bow on. Ho, ho, ho. You know what I mean?
And clothes.
Yeah, it ain't nothing like that. That's family. I ain't, you know what I mean? Ain't gonna unwrap me, baby. Like, no. But, you and I, like I said, we got history go way back, you know what I'm saying? Halo. the memories of the Halo days.
Halo was the second job.
It really was. When it first dropped, and
I'm ready to go. I'm like, yo, I gotta get out of here.
Right. Jay, like, I'm about to go home. I got work tomorrow. I'm like, wait, one more mission. One more chapter.
Then that turned into, dude, I just drive you out there. You get some clothes. You come back.
Pause it right there.
Get in the car. Go get some clothes.
We had many speeding sessions on the Jackie.
Yeah.
On the Jackie.
Yeah. All with Halo on the brand.
Yeah, you gotta get right back. We used to do that like about 45 minutes tops. Like, damn back in no time. Like, whew, good old days. Good old days. What are you playing nowadays? Any games still?
Man, I got games on the shelf and the wrapper.
That you don't even. Old and washed.
It's just that between getting home, doing what I do, and then get on the game, man, it's already like 10 o'clock.
I feel you.
I got Anthem.
Okay.
Got it when it was released.
Still ain't.
I put it on.
It's on the hard drive. Okay.
As far as I got.
You know, that's another thing that deters me from wanting to play. Because when you first get a game, it could be a midnight release, something you've been hyped for. Man, I wait 3 hours for it to download. You got to install, download, and update. Now you're like, man, I played tomorrow.
Yeah.
Then tomorrow come, you're like,
I need a nap.
Yeah.
Then it turns to, ooh, Friday.
Right.
And then Friday come. You get a call.
Right.
Hey, you want to? All right. Next thing you know, it's Sunday night.
Right.
You know, Sunday night said,
you got to prepare for Monday. Yeah. You just looking like, I got to iron this.
With that little dab of,
what?
Depression.
Oh,
the weekend. It's a little touching.
Because the weekend's over.
Yeah,
I feel you.
I mean, weekend is only about 5 minutes long.
It really is. I mean, you do stuff Friday night. Saturday, you might wake up late.
Yep.
Saturday, you doing some stuff. Sunday, you might wake up late. Now, you like...
You blame?
Sunday, you don't want to do nothing because it's like, I got to work tomorrow.
Yeah, I refuse to leave the house on Sunday.
Old and washed. That might be the title of this episode. old and washed.
It's not as bad as it seems.
It's not. I mean, you know, who knew we'd make it this far?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you know, we out here. We can still get the... I got a gray hair in my beard. You know what I mean? Sitting there somewhere, if you can see it.
Dude, I got a... We're not going to talk about what's in here because this is clear. I got 2 gray eyelashes. You know how I felt? When I saw them?
Got gray eyelashes.
2.
Okay. Okay, okay.
It was unsettling.
I don't think I do. I seem like it's like one. It's just one in the beard. And I've been letting my beard grow, too. I'm about to cut it. I never let it grow this long. I'm cutting it soon.
Just so you know, that gray, that's a scout.
I know. He checking like...
The whole team...
Follow me, boys.
...is on the way.
Yeah, I know. I don't mind that. You know, I had to cut the hair. The hair is bald now, top, so it's all coming down here now. But I want a little distinguished gray in the... You know what I mean? I'm like, you know...
Yeah, I mean, I'm not mad at mine, but, like I said... Mm-hmm. Who asked you to go to the eyelash?
Yeah, the eyelashes, that's a new one. I don't think I've seen too many gray eyelashes. Now, even the brow, a little bit, maybe, but I never seen the eyelashes.
And I was, you know, you get something in your eye.
Mm-hmm.
I was in the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
Where is it?
Mm-hmm.
What the hell is that? I thought it was a foreign object. It was a gray eyelash.
That's crazy. Well, like I said, you know, we video games is our thing. Also the music. I used to be a pusher man for the music.
What?
like, wait, hold on. What's the statute of limitation on that? I mean, what I mean is, I used to put you on to the music, unless the statute of limitation is up there. Yeah, let's download all that, get all that. But now everything is streaming, though.
Yeah.
So what are you listening to these days? What you rocking with these days?
These days, what I do for the most part is I go on Amazon or even YouTube.
Okay.
Put in an artist. Just let that shit roll.
Okay.
Because it's thin out there, man.
Yeah, it really is. It's
slim pickings for
real. It's a lot more music. It's not as much good music.
Right.
I feel like there's a new artist every day. It's just, they may have one song, you know, but it's like, it's not a lot of complete bodies of work that are... You know, something that. But what artists are you searching for when you do search?
Man. Like, lately it's just been just people I come across.
Okay.
Like, I don't feel like you can even go back to your old favorites and be like, what they got out now.
Right.
Because there now sounds like what else is out there.
And that's a problem, too.
Yeah.
A lot of them are not... They're trying to conform instead of push the bar, which what they used to do, which is what made them great, was they would stand out. Now they're like, oh, the kids are liking that. Let me do the kids liking. Like, let me do this trappy stuff and this, you know.
Yeah, trying to stay relevant. You old like me.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to. You know what I'm saying? So it's what it is. But like, and you know I always like some random.
Yeah.
So there's a dude named Alan Stone.
Okay.
White dude, soulful dude.
Okay, white soulful dude. Okay, yeah. Okay.
When you see him, you're like, he ain't gonna sing nothing.
And then he just,
blows. And he hits you.
Okay. Alan Stone. So the J recommendation.
Yeah, Alan Stone's a good dude.
Okay.
There's a female, Erin Allen Kane.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
She's good too.
Okay.
And rap has never really been my thing.
No, I don't know.
It is, you know, it's a random. random questionable situation.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a dude named Koji Radical. Some London dude.
Okay. Does he have that heavy London accent? Is because what they call that, the grind music, I think it is?
It's the London, but he's still got a little island thing to
him. Okay.
But it's kind of what's going on.
Has Drake gotten him yet?
No.
Drake like to jump on all the
no.
Okay.
But it's just...
He's still untainted.
Yeah.
Okay.
But the fact that just hearing something different, you know? Because still love my old stuff.
Of course.
My stylistics, my Dells.
Mm-hmm.
blue magic, all that kind of stuff. I told you I was old.
Old.
You know? Uh-huh. But I also just, like I said, I just surf through.
Okay.
And as long as it don't sound too crazy coming in, I play it a little bit.
Okay.
And I found a couple things.
Okay, so we got a couple recommendations there.
Yeah.
What was it again? It was Koji.
Koji Radical.
Koji Radical.
Aaron Allen Payne.
Aaron, mm-hmm.
And Alan Stone.
So everybody check those out. Recommended by Jay. If you don't like it, comment below. get at them.
If you don't like it, you didn't listen to the whole thing. Just like, let it
marinate a little bit.
Yeah, let it simmer.
Okay. Now, Tory Lanez recently dropped his Chicks Take 5. Now, you're familiar with Tory Lanez.
Yeah.
I'm trying to remember, because we were talking about it earlier, I'm trying to remember the one song that he did flip that was like his first hit. It's like on the tip of my tongue and I can't remember it.
What I realize some of the music that I get caught on.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Say It. He flipped the Say It.
Oh, okay.
He did, that was his first hit to really, and again, I'm going to put a little bit of it because YouTube be hating sometimes. But yeah, so that was kind of, he did that on like Chicks Tape 2 or 3 or something like that. And that became his thing. You know, he would flip the old 90s R&B joints.
Right.
And then he caught one with the Say It. You know, he's like, yeah, lying to me. Say It. He flipped it and made it a new song. And it was cool.
Right.
I listened to Chicks Tape 5 last week and I wasn't really feeling it. And, you know, and you are the R&B dude. You know, now you more the old school R&B dude, but this is like the 90s. You still know
that. Yeah, music is
so
music.
He got a couple joints with, he flipped Jagged Edge and Jermaine Dupri joint. So I'm going to let you hear a little bit of it. Let me see.
Analyzing now. Stand clear.
And this is the song, by the way. It's not me mixing. I'm not.
Right.
I know. Now Ashanti on the album cover is a good look.
Yeah.
Okay, you got the.
She growed up.
Yeah.
Let me see. Zoom in. I think it's cute.
You know what I mean? The lollipop and the sidekick.
Yeah. Sidekick. Wow.
Yeah. So this is him. I'm trying to remember what song this was. He flipped. Oh, Trade It All. Girl, I'll trade it all.
Okay.
So nothing like that.
No.
But. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean.
It's more grindy. It's more. he making it dirty. He making it like, you know, Trade It All was I won't say it a love song, but it was like, girl, I give it all away for you, like a kind of a, you know, I will take it down and
Made
give you
dirty.
The, you know what I'm saying? So this one was okay. It's just the stop and start. I wasn't feeling too much of it, and then they come in a little bit, and Jermaine Dupri is on here. Cause then he did another one. He did I'm Sprung with T-Pain.
Okay.
This one sticks more to the original. You can already tell.
Yeah. Real quick.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all like T-Pain? Singing T-Pain.
Oh yeah, so he was on the Masked Singer.
Yeah.
Tonight, gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive.
I have to say,
mm-hmm.
me and my wife was watching it,
mm-hmm.
and I called it out from the beginning.
You know it was him?
Yeah.
And have you heard him sing minus autotune before?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I didn't watch The Masked Singer, but I've heard him sing before. So I was like, yeah, if I would have watched the show, I ain't gonna say, but I probably would have called it too. But yeah, I saw on YouTube when the season was over and they ran through it. I was like, But there's a joint he did, I think it's called, I think it's NPR, Tiny Desk.
Yeah,
the joint. He did that, and he killed it. Like, that's no studio. That's just a microphone, some speakers, and your man's back there on the keyboard, the guitar. Like, and he killed it.
Yeah, he really did.
A lot of people don't know that T-Pain can, he found his niche with the, you know, with the auto-tune and stuff, but he can really sing.
Yeah, he's good.
You know, so, yeah.
Like, I found, thanks to NPR,
mm-hmm.
Tiny Desk, I found a lot of people. Like, that's where I first met Anderson .Paak. Not
okay.
met.
Mm-hmm. But, you know Anderson .Paak?
You know.
I said hi.
And he killed it on there.
Yeah.
So, it was Anderson .Paak,
mm-hmm.
this dude Lucky Day.
Yeah, no, Lucky Day, yeah.
You know, they do so much better on there than like...
And you know what? And that might be an issue too. It might be like the studio, like the labels and stuff now make you make a certain song.
Right.
You know, because everything now is and we're gonna talk about streaming services later, but everything now is digital. Yeah. So it's all about algorithms and what's working and the demographics and the numbers and the, and I think that's what hinders a lot of successful artists, because you know, once you get to the label, they're looking at it like, okay, they're not looking at the artist and what their talent is. They're saying, okay, we could sell you to this category.
Yep, product.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Than actual
music. And I think that's what a lot of the issue is with, like you said, music now. There's a lot more of it. It's just not as good. And that could be for us, because we're old and washed.
Yeah.
And, you know, but to some folks, and the thing is now with streaming is you don't have to sell the album.
Right.
You just need one or two songs that people are going to listen to over and over and over again. And I forget, it's like every 15,000 streams or something like that equals a downloaded digital sale.
Okay.
Or something crazy like that. So if you got one song that someone listened to over and over and over again, it counts as an album sale. And that's not really good.
No.
Because it would be to the point where we wouldn't buy that album.
Yeah.
I would listen to this song. And that was, you know, going back to the old and washed days, we'd record it on the radio or download it, just that song. I'm not buying the album.
Yeah.
Now, play that song over and over and over again, it counts as an album sale.
Right.
So it's like, I got to stop listening to it at $14,999. You know, stop right there. I can't play it no more.
Yeah.
Because he's going to get a sale for that. I don't give him a sale for that. No. I don't like it that much. I just like the song. The rest of the album sucks. You know, and that's you know, an issue where we're at now. But back to Tory real quick.
Yeah.
Because this is part of one of the ones I do like, but the I'm Sprung joint.
Okay. See, this to me is way better already. The last track, it sounded like the video was on, but I couldn't see it.
Mm-hmm.
And there was some other activities going on.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what the hell he's doing.
Right.
And then he came in.
Right. This one, I think, and a part of it could be too, because it's more to the original.
Right.
Because the last one sounded like the chopped and screwed version, like it was in the South and the DJ was mixing it, and you know, this one sounds more to the original, so that's probably what. And then T-Pain comes in here a little bit. He's on the hook, doing his T-Pain thing.
Right.
So, you know, that one I like because, and like I said, I probably like it because it sounds like a remix of the original.
Right.
You know, that one I could rock with. Then he got this one. Let me stop it because Beauty and the Benz is this one with Snoop Dogg, and they remix Beautiful.
Okay.
With Pharrell and Snoop joint. And then he kind of goes back to the whole Chopped and Screwed thing again.
I mean, I hate to say it,
mm-hmm.
but when I hear that,
mm-hmm.
I see Chris Brown in my head.
Mm.
It all just... And I don't mean it, you know, I don't want nobody to attack me.
Stop and make sure we don't get that pop flag. So now what makes you think of Chris Brown when you...
It's the same sound to me.
Mm. Okay.
You can get by because you got samples of whoever or whatever in the background.
Mm-hmm.
But if you singing similar words in a similar tone in a similar style,
sound like Chris Brown to you.
I feel like, all right, if you're a Tory Lanez fan, then you see it for what it is.
Right.
But for me, he just sounds like another
thing. And I think Tory Lanez has yet to really find his lane. No pun intended. Because like I said, this is the fifth Chicks tape. And so that's five projects of him doing this, remixing old songs.
Right.
He got two albums. The second one really wasn't that good. The first one's okay. But I think people would know him for the remixes.
So,
yeah.
A person could say, that he getting by on past success. Because, I mean, it's a lot of things that
past
you get tricked
success
into.
Or kind of like, and don't get me wrong, I'm not hating, because it's a talent still to even remix an old song, because he's kind of remixing them and giving them a different feel.
Right.
So that's a talent in itself. It's just that there's a big difference between that and a blank canvas.
Yeah.
You know, because to do the Sprung, and I think it's titled Jerry Sprunger.
Okay.
You know, but the hook is still the Sprung. And yeah. So you're not, the song has the same idea still.
Yeah.
You're not starting with a blank canvas, hearing a beat and saying, let's make a song about me being sprung over a girl.
Yeah.
You know, what do you think about, you know, you're not starting for the blank. So, and I think that was an issue with Fab, you know, in the rap world. That's always been my concern with Fab. His albums have never really been great. He's had good albums, okay albums, but a lot of his mixtape stuff has been good, and that's where he takes other people's beats and kind of rap over them, freestyles, what have you, but or add verses to the song that exists, and it's kind of like he's not really as good with a blank, clean slate as he is with, here's the hook, the beat, and make another verse to it.
Because they lure you in with something you already like.
Right.
And give it a chance.
Yeah, and when it's already a hit, then half the work is done for you.
Yeah.
you know what I mean? Did you listen to Chris's last album? Cause he had the Heartbreak and the Full Moon. Well, he re-released it. So I think that was the last album actually.
I went through the album like once.
Okay. It's like 40 something songs.
Yeah. And I mean, it was cool. There was some songs that I was like, all right. And I mean, it could be the old thing again, but
old and washed.
When I go, like, cause I usually do it on the bus going into work.
Okay.
So when I go back, if I see something else, I get distracted.
Okay.
But there were a couple of tracks of his that I like.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I can't remember the last time I actually bought a full, a full album or anything.
Okay.
But I feel like 40 tracks, you can spend a little money and take a chance.
Right.
You know,
you got it. Ain't got to be a good 12 to 15.
Yeah, out of 40.
Hopefully 20 that you can find on that you like. Yeah.
And for a while, I have to say for a while, I was like, I don't like old Chris.
You're like old Chris? Oh, you're older Chris.
Yeah,
you're
like, young Chris.
Okay, got you.
He was
fun. What made you feel that way?
I don't know. He was looking a little rough.
Well, I mean, like after the assault case and things? And
not even that. Okay. People do stuff. Stuff happens.
Stuff happens.
Yeah.
Okay.
But I guess he went so far from what we first met him as to what he turned into.
Mm-hmm.
It felt forced.
Okay.
But now, I get to feel, it feels like, okay, that's who he is.
Got you.
So now I take the music a little more, for it.
Okay.
But before, it was a little like, come on, what are you doing?
And I think, too, going back to the old streaming thing, you know, he 40 songs, I guess he's playing it differently. Instead of saying, here's one song to play over and over and over again, here's 40 that you'll just probably just press guaranteed 40 plays every time you listen.
Yeah.
Instead of one song 40 times, here's 40 joints, you might listen to one, so, you know. I think everybody's trying to find the catch to the algorithm thing.
Right.
You know.
I mean, but when it comes down to it, as long as his fans like it, I don't have to like it.
True.
You know what I mean?
True.
Especially since I ain't buy it.
Right. Right.
I mean, you know. So, hey, if it's making him happy, he's making other people. Like, I know a few friends of mine, their kids, of course, young girls.
Mm-hmm.
My friends with their daughters.
But I was about to say, I can't be promoting.
No, come on, man.
I'm just.
Not at all.
Just make it yours.
No.
Woo. Okay.
So, like, they'll freak out when they know he coming to town.
Okay, got you.
And if you have that kind of effect,
right,
you're doing something right. It really
especially because he's been in the game for some time now. So
yeah,
he got the new crop of young girls. Because his original young fan base is now adults.
Yeah.
So now he got a new group, so that shows his longevity and stuff too, because he was young when he first started. Now he's in his 30s.
And when
is he 30 yet? I don't even know. Is Chris yet? Chris Brown?
I mean,
he gotta be like early 30s. Carried one?
Yeah.
He's born in 89, so yeah, he just turned 30.
Okay.
He just turned 30 this year, so yeah, so that's what I'm saying. So he started when he was like, 15, 16 or something like that. So he's been in the game about 15 years.
Okay.
So, yeah. So,
I mean, he does have good stuff. I'm not saying he don't have good stuff.
Right.
I'm just mad picky sometimes.
I got you. You know what I mean? I got you.
Like, I don't want to fight. I don't necessarily want to be amped up to feel like I want to fight.
Okay.
I'm not going to treat women bad.
Okay.
I don't have sides and extra pieces and
so,
and I don't want to live vicariously through you, Chris.
Got you.
So
that's not for you.
No, give me some gold.
Are there any songs on the last album that stood out to you, though, that you do?
I think it was off the last one.
Mm-hmm.
What's this called? damn it.
I mean, 40 songs, so it's hard to remember. Because like I said, I usually just put it on and then press play. So I can't really remember myself, like, the names of the songs, because... Yeah.
Part of me want to say Transition, but it's not.
Oh, Indigo was the last one. Excuse me. Indigo was the last one. Heartbreak on the Full Moon was before that.
So,
and then he re-released that again a couple times, I think. And yeah, so Indigo. Indigo was the last one. So, and then he did Indigo with the extended version. So originally Indigo was 32 tracks. So we got Indigo, Back to Love, Come Together, Temporary Lover, Emerald, Burgundy. Two colors, red, another color. All I Want, Wobble Up. That's the shout out to the strip clubs, the twerkers and things, the wobble joint. Need a Stack, Eat Heat, No Guidance. That was with Drake. Girl of Dreams, Natural Disaster, Aura. Don't Check on Me.
What the hell was I listening to?
I don't even know. It's a lot of songs. I don't remember what songs I might like. It's just like put it on and just let it rock.
So maybe it was an older one.
Maybe.
No, but they was.
Can you hum a few bars? You remember the. Remember what it sounded like? Did you remember the melody?
Tempo.
Tempo.
Switch up the tempo.
Okay, wait, hold on.
I don't know where that is.
Tempo?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. Okay, it started up.
Yeah.
Tempo.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's on the Indigo album.
And that's the part that got me.
So this would kind of make you feel like the Tory Lanez song?
Sort of.
Okay.
And he did it better.
Okay.
it makes sense.
Okay. Again, I can't play too much of it because, you know.
Yeah.
Get flagged. But y'all, Chris Brown tempo, go look for it. Okay, I got you.
So it's a weird video, but it's cool as shit.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I can say shit right now.
You can say it. Can't say too many of them, because again, YouTube be tripping sometimes.
Yeah.
I think, you know, all the audio joints don't mind, but YouTube be sometimes, they be like, you know, the kids might be listening.
And I've been good so far, because you know how I get down.
Yeah. But, you know, y'all listeners and viewers, let me know what y'all listen to R&B-wise right now. What's on your playlist? The end of the year is coming up, too. Me and the homie Big John, shout out to Big John. We do yearly review.
Okay.
We call it The Hands of Time, a.k.a. Thot. so that's coming up. That will be airing sometime in December. I don't know when yet. But, yeah, we're going to do that. And so what do y'all listen to? You know, what movies did you see this year? Any movies stood out to you this year? Anything good? Like any movies that you were like, yeah, that's crazy, or you know, did you go to the movies? Let me start there. Not to say that you don't.
No,
a lot of people don't.
Because
nowadays.
I don't.
Right. That's what I'm saying. A lot of people now go for like one or two things, and it's not too many things. Because I think the theaters actually said money is lower now. Like, I mean, ticket sales are down except for like the Marvel movies and stuff. Like, that's the only thing really bringing people to the theater. So
$100 a ticket.
It's close enough.
So
after you, the ticket price, the concessions, and yeah,
and let the food be good.
And they shout out to Magic Johnson, the AMC theater. They got the chicken and waffle sandwich.
Really?
It's the waffle joint, and it's pretty good. Not to be a foodie or a fat man, but hey. It's pretty good. I went to a matinee one time, and it was kind of like breakfast brunch time.
Right.
And I was like, I don't want to eat that heavy. I'm just, you know. And I was like, all right.
Wait a minute.
Let me get that. And I saw that on the menu. And I was like, okay, this is. I'm in the mood. Like, I have to give me another one of these. So shout out to y'all for that.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
If we have a legal situation here.
Uh-oh.
Do you remember? We were the first to put a fucking burger on a waffle.
You may be right, but somebody got a waffle burger?
Buffalo chicken is close enough.
I mean, well, see, well, Roscoe was doing that over in Cali for like, I don't know how long.
He wasn't here.
True. It's bigger now. I don't know who really made the chicken and waffle thing famous, but I've heard about Roscoe's chicken and waffle for years. Like, that's been, right. You know, every time we watch a show that, you know, was set in Cali, L.A., whatever, they talk about Roscoe's, so.
But was it a sandwich?
I don't think it was a sandwich, no.
Because I remember at Chuck Rip, made burgers.
You might be on to something.
We was like, man, no bread.
You might be on to something.
And I was like, it's waffles in there.
We might, you know. Well, listen, you might want to hold on to it. I might have to delete that part because I don't think nobody did burgers.
White Castle's doing that.
White Castle got that?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I have one.
Oh, okay. Was it good at least?
Yes, sir.
Well, speaking of which, since we kind of off the music thing now, so let's try. I got a third top of pot in my head. Have you had the Popeye's chicken sandwich?
No.
Are you interested in the Popeye's chicken sandwich? Okay, cool.
And the reason why, like, there's stuff that I'll go out and have, but I'm not like a chef, but I cook.
Right.
So when I buy something and it don't taste good, I'll be upset, so I just make it myself.
Okay.
So
you've made the Popeye's chicken sandwich?
Man, I've made many things.
Okay.
So, I mean, no, but we didn't have the Popeye's chicken sandwich. But one day, actually the last time my mom was up here, we ordered Wendy's, Meats. And they got some old bacon, jalapeno, blah, 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 chicken sandwich.
Got you.
And I passed.
Okay.
I was like, I'm not. And between the time it got here and when we ordered, I went in there. And I made mine. Just so happened to have some jalapenos in the refrigerator. And I made it. And I killed it.
Did anybody else have some?
Yeah, let them taste it. There.
Oh, and it was like, yours is better?
Yeah.
There you go. That. Oh,
but that, I mean, convenience as to, let's do it. But, I mean, I'm not going to get online and wait super long for a sandwich. That could be questionable.
True.
Now, if somebody was online, it was like, I get cuts and I get in. That's one thing.
Well, that's one of the things. Last week on the episode, me, Nan, and Crystal was talking about in Maryland. In Maryland, someone actually cut in line, and the dude stabbed him. Wow. And I was saying, people were chalking it up to, oh, he stabbed him over the chicken sandwich. And I was saying, no, he stabbed because he cut in line.
Yeah,
it could have been over anything. He cut in line. That's the part that. Was warranted the stabbing. People, you know, a lot of people say, oh, they be doing all this for a chicken. I'm like, yeah, but he cut in line.
You totally disrespecting me.
Yeah.
Because had you said, man, let me jump in.
Right.
You had a chance.
Right.
But you bullied me.
Right.
I happen to have some pointy.
I just happen to have a thing on me.
Have a little bit of it.
Right. Do you feel like people are going crazy over the sandwich? Yeah.
I mean, but...
Are you at least curious about it?
I am. Well, I was until I saw it automatically came with mayonnaise on it. Now I feel like mayonnaise.
But it's like a special mayonnaise or like a... That sounds weird. it's a spicy, I think. But no, I think if you get the spicy one, it's a spicy mayonnaise or whatever. If you don't, it might be regular or something. I don't know.
I don't do mayonnaise.
Or maybe you could tell them no sauce?
I mean...
Maybe? I don't know.
I'll wait till it cool down again. But I have to say... And not just the Popeyes thing, but they make shit look so good. Like, commercials now are like that shelf in the supermarket that's right before the register.
Right, yeah, and you like standing there.
Yeah.
And you just see it.
I gotta have it. Just so happens that I'm not the type of person.
And that's the hype beast culture.
Yeah.
Because, you know, typically associated with like sneakers.
Right.
You know, oh, limited release, you know, limited time, da da da. Now they've Popeyes, because like there's no Popeyes chicken sandwich commercial. It's a lot of it is word of mouth. A lot of it is, oh my God, I had this is great. Let me see. Oh my God, I had this is great. Let me see. Post it online. I got one. I want one. You know, and then they sold out of them.
Yeah.
So I think a lot of it is that hype beast tactic is promoting it. You know, because I haven't had it. Again, like I said last week, I love the Popeye's chicken strips. Yeah. And I saw the price on that went down, so I might holler. I haven't been to Popeye's in a minute, but I really don't want to go because of a line. I'm like, I don't even want that. Is there a line for like uppers? Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, can I just give me the 3-piece strips with the fries and a biscuit? Like, can I just get that and bounce? Like, why they wait for that? Like, I don't want that.
Yo, you know what I'm saying? Popeye's biscuit, bro.
The Popeye's, they just dry. You just get right up in here.
I don't care.
They just, it's just up in here. You need you a drink, like
when
you know.
When it's warm.
Oh yeah, but they don't even give you the jelly no more. They used to give you the jelly. Now you gotta add. You gotta be like, yo, can I get a jelly? They be like, oh.
Like it's. If there's anybody out there,
talk to them.
And you work in food services, mm-hmm. whatever you want to call it. Mm-hmm. Those are not your condiments. Look at me. Mm-hmm. You're gonna see me come up.
Okay.
Say to yourself, he could probably use about 4 or 5 honey mustards.
Right.
Come on. Don't charge me a quarter, possibly 50 cents, depending on where you at. They're not yours.
Do you think they take inventory on those?
They shouldn't.
Do y'all take inventory on those? I want to know. I used to work in retail. I never worked in fast food, but do y'all take inventory on the sauces?
Like, if you do, stop. I know who don't take inventory, but they act like it's gold.
Who?
The Chinese restaurant.
Oh, the soy sauces and stuff? Yeah, they be having those in boxes. Like, yeah, they definitely don't. Yeah. And they give you like 2 duck, 2 soy, 2 hot sauce.
Don't expect to get a hot mustard unless you ask
for it. Unless you ask for it, and you might get one.
Selfish.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But yeah, it's crazy. If somebody bought me a Popeye's chicken sandwich, mm-hmm. no mayonnaise.
No mayo, okay.
I would get on it.
Okay, no doubt.
Do they come with cheese?
I don't think so.
I don't want it then.
You can put some cheese on if you want. I want
my cheese to melt with the chicken and the bread together. I don't want afterthought cheese.
When you make your own.
Yeah, man, when I make mine.
Jay's chicken sandwich coming soon, y'all.
Listen. Spicy.
On a waffle.
Mild.
On a waffle.
I could do a waffle. I could do a waffle.
Mm-hmm.
Waffle sliders too.
So all right. So you mentioned your love for the biscuit.
Yeah.
Who got the better biscuit? Popeyes. Red Lobster. Who else got biscuits? Well, between them two, let me just leave it simple. Keep it simple. Who got the better biscuit? The Cheddar Bay biscuit from Red Lobster, or the Popeyes biscuit? Or any other one you can think of that might be better.
So to start with, between Popeyes and Red Lobster,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to give it to Red Lobster.
Okay.
Reason being, because as much as I love a Popeyes biscuit, you're right, mm-hmm. it's a little dry.
Man, it's a little good, bit of vanilla.
And the Red Lobster, when you get it fresh mm-hmm. out.
Fluffy.
Man.
It's fluffy.
It changed your life.
It's fluffy.
It really do.
It's fluffy.
But I think the best biscuit I've had, and I don't even know if they're still around.
Mm-hmm.
They damn sure not here.
Okay.
Church's biscuits.
Mm.
They had the little honey glaze on it.
Yeah, I don't think there's no Church's.
The last time I had one, it was actually in a White Castle's.
Yeah, And I don't even think, I haven't even seen that no more. I don't even think they still like blended or whatever anymore. I haven't seen a Church's inside. Yeah, you're right.
But a church's
mm-hmm.
biscuit with the honey glaze on it, man. It was, I went, of course, post hangout.
So everything was great when you, you know, a couple little drinks in you. Little,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I went there and I bought just a box of biscuits. All I want is the biscuits. Is for chicken? No, I'm good.
That's right.
The biscuits, please.
Right.
And I was a fat boy.
Mm-hmm.
Go home, crumbs mm-hmm. on my jacket.
Crumbs on the jacket.
Cold,
mm-hmm.
eating warm biscuits. Okay. Try to get home.
Okay.
So it holds a special place for me.
But it was a good night.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what's up.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Listen, everybody listening, everybody watching, what do y'all think? Either the Red Lobster Cheddar Bay biscuits or the Popeyes biscuits or one of your choice. Which one is the best? Let me know. Comment below. You know, let's get that conversation going because I just, you know, thought about that. I myself would probably agree. I would say that the Red Lobster joints is probably better. I don't think I ever had the Church's biscuit. I don't think I ever had one. I've had like the little local chicken spot biscuits.
Right.
You know, when they're just throwing there, they give you the roll, the biscuits extra, you know. But I've had them joints, throw a little jelly on there. But the Popeye's joints is probably. The cheddar, I mean, actually, it's cheddar on it, so that's what makes it a little different. You don't need to put no jelly or nothing on the Red Lobster joint. So, That's probably what meant, that probably why I would have to say go with the Red Lobster one.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But that's the foodie talk. Old and washed, that's what we are, that's, you know, that's what we talk about.
And I eats.
And we you can see, you already know.
It's an important part of life.
It really is. But last but not least, we were talking about streaming and digital streaming earlier, and some people would say the streaming wars for entertainment has begun. Netflix was the king of the hill for years. Disney Plus just launched last week.
Yeah.
I've been saying on the show for, you know, for those that have been listening and watching, I've been saying for the longest that Disney Plus is definitely going to take the top spot. They have a lot of independent properties and a lot of license to a lot of shows and you know, categories and things. And once the app launched, I seen it and I was like, yeah, they got a lot. Like I said it before, but sometimes seeing is believing. And once I saw it, you know, I had the app. I waited. I was gonna wait. I'm not gonna lie, I was gonna wait. I knew the initial launch would have some bugs, issues, whatever. So I waited till I got home. I didn't wait a day. I waited till I got home. I didn't get it from midnight or whatever, whenever when it launched. I waited till I got home, did the free trial, and I just was scrolling, and I was just like, oh, they got that.
Yeah.
Oh, they got that. Oh, they got that. Oh, they got, you know, and I was just like, you know, so you have the plus,
yeah,
well.
Yeah.
Did you do like the one of the yearly bundles, or did you do anything?
First off, I'm not giving nobody nothing.
Okay.
Promise me, yeah, I might not see the whole damn year.
Okay. True. That is a good point. Okay, so you're doing monthly?
But
okay,
I did sign up the week before it came out.
Okay.
Paid version.
Okay.
Because I saw online somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
You know, certain apps snoop on you,
mm-hmm,
and they throw what you're interested in up there magically.
Okay. Yeah.
And
shout out to all the AI that's in the, you know, the Alexas and the Googles and the, yeah. Shout out to y'all.
Y'all appreciate it because you've been hooking me up lately. You kidding me?
Right.
But I looked at a good amount of what was going to be there,
mm-hmm,
and I was like, wow, I've been trying to see this stuff for a long time.
Right.
And then they had it.
Right.
So the morning it released, I'm on the bus going into work,
mm-hmm,
so I tried to get on.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't let me on.
Right.
Got a little frustrated.
Mm-hmm. And I've seen people saying they were having initial login issues. Some people were having issues with it. They would see everything and they click on something and they would be like, nothing. Hold on for a minute.
Yeah.
We coming. Just wait a minute. Yeah.
And then I caught myself.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, calm down. You've seen this stuff before.
Right.
So I waited.
Mm-hmm.
Around lunchtime at work,
mm-hmm,
found a little corner.
Okay,
went in.
Mm-hmm.
So they had gummy bears.
that was the one that did it for you.
Yeah,
gummy bears.
Gummy bears. I played the song.
Mm-hmm.
I was in the seat like this. I was young again.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that I they are definitely a heavy hitter.
Mm-hmm.
Will they knock Netflix out completely? I don't know. And the reason why I say that is Netflix, they have been doing really well,
mm-hmm,
with their movies and whatnot that come directly from them.
Okay.
Like, they have some stuff on there that after you watch it, I'm like, yo.
But which movies?
Well, a lot of people won't agree, but I like Bright. I was a fan.
Really? You like Bright?
I like Bright.
How about the technical?
No, really.
It was okay. I'm not gonna. It was okay, but I didn't watch it again.
But you know, I'm
True, but I mean,
so that falls into my
okay.
I mean, in this,
I did like the I can't think of the name of it. When I was down at Naya's house a couple months ago, we watched this joint. This time travel joint. I can't think of the name of it. Man, I can't remember the name.
It's new.
I think, yeah, it was new. It was basically,
See you tomorrow, see you yesterday, something like that?
I don't remember. Let me see if I can find it real quick. Something in time or something like a full moon, something crazy. I don't remember the name. I can't remember the name, but the whole premise of it is there's some chick in like a hoodie or something.
Yes, I saw it.
Yeah, and then the dude's chasing her,
yeah,
and then it goes back 5 or 7 years. It's something crazy like that.
It was good.
I can't remember the name. You remember the name?
It should be in my... What's the name?
Yes, I'm trying to think of the...
It was good because it wasn't...
Like Shadow of the Moon.
Yeah.
In the Shadow of the Moon, that's what it is.
I went in not knowing what it was. Because, you know, it rolled into the next
show. Yeah, yeah.
So I rolled into it.
And it was one of those, you know, Netflix recommended this. And I'm like, what's this about? And I think I read it, and I was like, all right. And we watched it. And it turned into one of the murder mystery type joints. Like, what's going on?
Where'd
she go? Is she dead? Is she, you know, what's going on? Like, is he bugging? Right. Everybody think he bugging, and the scientists and that. I saw that, and I believe that's a Netflix original.
Yeah,
I don't, because I remember hearing about it in movies and like that. So yeah, I mean they got that one. I wasn't a big fan of Bright.
I liked Bright. I mean,
I hated Bird Box.
I didn't watch it.
Good.
Why? Because, like, if people talk too much about it, I don't want to see it now.
Right.
Because then you want to talk to me about it.
Right.
This is different.
Yeah.
But then you got people like, did you watch it? I didn't fucking watch it.
Right.
Sorry. I didn't watch it.
Yeah. See, and Shadow of the Moon was 2019. So, yeah, I believe it was straight to Netflix. I think, does it say Netflix original or anything on it? I don't think it don't say it nowhere in the phone. I think it's a Netflix original, yeah. Bird Box, I wasn't a fan of. Because I feel like it was so bad that people that liked it are trying to tell themselves it was good.
Okay.
Because people are like, yo, you don't get it. See, it's deep. See, she's blind. Because in society, you can't see what's going on with the man blindfolding you. And then, and it's like,
so that means if you don't like it, you're just not ready.
You're just not woke.
Yeah.
See, you blind. You can't see the demons around us. And you know what I mean? And it's just like, nah, it was a bad movie.
Yeah.
It was really a bad movie. Like, they tried to get metaphorical, but it's like blatantly obvious, and it's just like a lot of convenience and a lot of just like, oh, they made it, and oh, they ended up surviving in a school for the blind. Oh, what do you know? They ended up, you know, riding the boat, and the sanctuary is a school for the blind. Everybody can't see. Oh,
yeah,
they survived. So everyone that's blind in the world is worthy of living? You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't make any sense. It was just, you know, and it was a book. And the book had a more darker ending.
Okay.
Where I think she, like, scratches her eyes out to survive or something like that. Something crazy like that. Netflix was like, we're going to do a PG-13. They're going to make it to a school for the blind. We're not going to do all that dramatic eye scratching. No. But
some stuff just don't need to be edited. I mean, change. Yeah. Just give us, like, if you're going to do a book, granted, you can't, like, I recently, like, maybe last year, everybody, for the most part, like, have you read, what is it, A Stitch in Time?
A Wrinkle in Time?
There you go, Wrinkle in Time.
Yeah,
Time. And as a kid or whatever, I never read it. And the movie was coming out, so I did the audiobook. I refused to read. Audiobook is the best. It's like being a kid again. Somebody just reading to you.
Right, right.
So
you just close your eyes, sit back, and just
And it was good, but it was long. And then when I see the movie, and it's like you can't squeeze this into an hour and some change when the audiobook was a good 15 some hours. So certain books shouldn't be transferred into movies.
And that's what happens too when they try to make long books into an hour movie. And again, it goes back to like demographic analytics. The hour, 15, 20 minutes sweet spot, and da da da. And it's like, no, you can't do that. It need to be a series, or it need to be a TV show. Or, you know, say a series online.
Yeah, and then they cut out the good stuff. They leave in the things that people who don't pay attention, who don't think about the actual what they're watching, they leave that stuff in. But the good stuff they take out is the real where the feeling comes from.
And that's what I feel about Bird Box. I feel like they kept it very bland or on the surface. It was very simplistic that people that liked it want to tell me that it's deeper than what it really is. Right. And it's really not. Like, you know, everything they said, I got it. But then it contradicted itself in the next scene, you know, it was like that.
Yeah.
But getting back to the streaming service, you know, wars and stuff, Disney Plus launched, and Netflix's counteraction was signing a deal with Nickelodeon. And initially when I heard that, I was just like, It was like, Nickelodeon, you know, my cousin Skeeter, Kenan and Kel, Double Dares, I mean. I'm right, like, right. But you brought up something that may be a little interesting, and then that was...
Avatar Last Airbender.
Right. So that's one Nickelodeon original that I could be like, you know what, I would watch that. But that's one show, and I believe the original one had 3 seasons, and the Korra series had 2 seasons or one?
It was 2. Korra was a little weak.
Yeah.
But I think it was only like 2.
And if you watch the original Aang series, was Kitty.
Yeah.
Now, I haven't seen it in a while. So as an adult, we old and washed. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's still going to hold the same value. But part of the deal that Netflix and Nickelodeon cut is originals. So they might either make a new season or we don't know where they might go with this deal. They're going to own the properties and make some original properties too.
That would be a smart move
to use that title
that could be
and go back to Aang.
Yeah, that's a good flagship because even though on the surface you got, it's Kitty. It is. Right. It's about kids.
Yeah.
But it gives you a view of how important friends are to kids, and if you open yourself up to being a kid again, I guess it's kind of heavy because this dude gotta save the whole world. I'm bald. I got an arrow on my head. I got this dude with me. I got this chick with
me
who like me but don't like me.
And the bad kid, the firebender
Zuko,
he ended up realizing my pops is wilding a little bit. Let me chill with me, run with y'all.
And his story, a lot of people overlook, but his story was a heavy story.
No, yeah, for sure. Zuko's story was deep, you know, because again, it's like you said, it the undertones is kind of like, not race, what race? The firebenders and the airbenders, they was like a race, so they were all separated by their, you know, techniques and their styles. So the show itself kind of was like, you know, about different, you know, because the firebenders use a lot of mechanical stuff. They use like machineries, and the earthbenders was more, you know, earthly. And,
yeah,
you know, so Zuko's story, you know, kind of was on some. We don't have to be this way.
Yeah,
we could be a little nicer to the rest of the world, and so I could see them bringing that back. But I just don't think Nickelodeon.
Has weight.
Yeah. Now, because like I said, on previous episode, discussed this before, I feel Netflix's best bet would be to focus on the comedy specials.
Okay.
The documentaries.
Which is good.
And that's their niche. And low-budget videos. Straight to DVD type movies. Straight to Netflix type movies.
Right.
Because that's the angle that, you know, Disney's right now is... all the big budget stuff. Star Wars, Marvel, you know, Pixar, all their big budgets. And a lot of PG-13 stuff. Hulu's going to probably get their more R-rated stuff. So I think the Logans and the Deadpools are going to probably go to Hulu.
Right.
Once they get total control of Hulu. They have total control of it, but I believe Universal has another percentage until they roll into their Peacock streaming service, which is also coming soon, which is NBC Universal. So then Hulu will probably be able to get some of the more Disney adult-themed content. But I think Netflix should focus on... And maybe the Nickelodeon will be their angle, too, to get some kid stuff, too.
Right.
But I think they should focus on the comedy specials. You know, you got Chappelle on there, Chris Rock. You got, you know, the Amy Schumers. You got a bunch of comedy specials. Then the straight-to-video stuff. You know, Dolomite Is My Name, Eddie Murphy. Stuff like that. The documentaries, The Making of Murderers, stuff like that's on there.
Dude, I watched that. I love it.
See what I'm saying? That's their thing.
It's horrible what people do to each other. But it's so interesting to watch.
Right. A lot of their documentaries are what kind of... Because I remember, you know, I want to say about 5-6 years ago, right? I'm at my homegirl crib, you know, Netflix and chilling. and luckily, and that's like I said, it's about 5-6 years. It's about 6 years ago, I want to say. She wanted to watch The Notebook.
Okay.
Wasn't on there. Search for it, wasn't on there.
Was she happy?
She wanted to watch. Then she said, check Twilight. Wasn't on there. So we ended up watching some other, some horror movie, something that we was actually going to go to the theaters to see. We didn't end up seeing it. We watched it on there. Cool. But I say that to say, like, at that time, about 6 years ago, Netflix really had nothing. And I remember telling Naya, because I used Naya's password to log in and stuff. Shout out to my sister. And I was like, it ain't got nothing on Netflix. And this is like 6 years ago.
Right.
Then they started to get, like, some traction. I want to say when they started maybe their original shows, maybe. When the Marvel shows came on there. Right. Sort of Daredevil, Stranger Things, Making a Murderer, the documentary. Stuff like that started to really gain. When it got Black Mirror, stuff like that kind of is what made them pop a little bit. So I think if they stick to low, and I don't want it to sound like it's a bad thing, but the low budget be the low budget angle, because Disney's gonna be the $100 million budget movies, right. You know, the Star Wars, so the Marvels, and
so the little known good movies.
Yeah,
that you stumble across.
Yeah. Cause there's like they don't have the Tyler Perry's, but they got the other black movies. They got you'll see like the movies starring like Marcus Houston.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You'll see movies like starring him and like it was the dude that played Falcon. It was him until he got the Marvel deal.
Right.
But he'd be in those straight to black movies. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like them kind of movies is on there, and then the comedy specials. You got the Amy Schumer's. You got the Chris Rock tambourine on there. Monique is actually suing them now. She wanted to be on there though. you know what I mean? But that's what Disney won't do.
Yeah.
So I think their way to survive would be to lower their price point and stop spending so much on, because they gave Dave Chappelle $60 million for I think four shows or two, three shows. Now, he did like six in total over like 2-3 years. So I guess that works out in the long run, but it's not growing. I don't know if they're growing subscribers from that.
Right.
They don't have commercials. They don't have, so their only budget, their only revenue is subscriptions every month. So unless you're growing subscriptions, you're just counting the same amount of numbers of $12.99 every month.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I don't know if they can grow anymore.
I mean, everybody's going to reach their peak.
Right.
And what I was going to say, which you hit on it, was when I thought about Disney, it's like, what will they, like, what are the things that they're not going to show?
Right.
Because they're not going to show you the bloody,
right,
or the, what do you want to call it?
The R-rated, but that's what they're,
right.
That's what they're throwing in Hulu, because that's what they're doing. They're doing the whole bundle for $12.99 is like Disney Plus, Hulu, and ESPN Plus.
Right.
And Hulu's gonna be their, and again, it's not gonna be just the R-rated stuff. I think they're also gonna put, like, cause with their Fox merger, they also got FX. So like Atlanta, you know, Charles Gambino joined Atlanta, and like Archer, cause Disney Plus has all the Simpsons episodes.
Yeah.
So I think Hulu might have Archer.
That would make sense.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So I think that's their way of counteracting it. But the thing, a lot of people don't realize, Disney owns Hulu. And, you know, so that's the difference maker. They may have to give in to being so kid-friendly and, you know, proper, and just throw it all under the Disney umbrella.
Yeah.
Make it one app. Because it's like, $12.99 for three apps sound good, but most people are going to be like, well, I don't need three apps.
Yeah.
So I'll just pay the $6.99 for the one.
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? But if they did, I don't want them to charge $12.99, but if they did like $10.99 for the one app and it has a Hulu section and an ESPN section, then it would be smarter to me. I'm not going to tell Disney how to do their business.
Yeah.
But to me, it would make sense for them to have one app.
Because you're more likely to go into it knowing that you don't have to flip between apps.
Right. One app that got it all. And they're doing it now, because when you go into it, it's, you know, Disney, Pixar, Marvel, Star Wars, and the National Geographic.
Yeah.
Which I thought I wasn't going to mess with the National Geographic tab. Yeah. They got Brain Games on there. I love Brain Games.
Yeah.
If you watch Brain Games, I love Brain Games. The first season, the third season, they kind of went a different style with the show.
Right.
But I love Brain Games. Yeah, I love Brain Games. So I even watched the Jeff Goldblum show. He had a show on there, like A Day in the Life of Jeff Goldblum. And the first episode was like sneaker culture.
You know what? It's in my queue.
Yeah, I watched it.
It's in my queue.
Cause Jeff Goldblum's one of them quirky dudes.
Yeah.
So what are you talking about?
That's the type of dude that you want to be next to at a party.
Yeah. So I watched it and I was like, okay, it's interesting. So I'm watching episode 2 and I'm watching, you know what I'm saying? So Netflix don't have a Jeff Goldblum and I don't think they should try to.
Yeah, they need to be their own thing.
Stick to their comedies, stick to the documentaries. I go to, and like I said, but they need to lower the price point. So if they lower the price point and lower what they're spending, you know, I think they could survive. Because next year, we're getting, like I said, Peacock is coming, mm-hmm. which is Channel 4, NBC Universal.
Right.
Universal got a lot of movies. NBC got a lot of shows. But the big deal is going to be HBO Max, which is Warner Brothers,
okay.
HBO, and a bunch of stuff. And they're going to have a catalog similar to Disney's, because Warner Brothers has obviously the Looney Tunes.
Right.
So you're going to have the Looney Tunes, Hanna-Barbera,
yeah.
which is the old Flintstones, Jetsons and all that old Jetsons. Stuff, right? Then you're going to have Turner Classic,
okay.
TNT, the old movies.
Right.
So people want to see the Casablancas and the Gone with the Winds. You're going to have that stuff. So now you got the kids with the cartoons, the Flintstones, well, us at least, that's yeah. old enough. You're going to have that. But then you got the Looney Tunes, which also means like probably the Roger Rabbits and stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I
think Roger Rabbits on Disney Plus, though, I think. So it should be Bugs. So Bugs and Space Shams and Space Sham 2 and LeBron's filming.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. But then you're going to have, like I said, the Hanna-Barbera. Then you got the old school classics. Then you have the new stuff. Turner. And then it's HBO. So they're going to have their adult-themed content as well on there. Not, and I don't mean like X-rated stuff. But I mean like the cursing and some blood.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I think HBO Max. And they're going to have Cartoon Network, Adult Swim. Yeah, so that's South Park, Robot Chicken, what you call it, Space Ghost is getting a talk show again, so
okay.
Space Ghost is going to be like a weekly show on it, so they're going to have like the late night content show on there. So I think HBO Max may be the biggest competitor to Disney Plus, but that's already two competing against Netflix, and that's not even counting, like I said, Peacock, which is NBC Universal, Amazon Prime still around.
I'm rocking with Amazon Prime right now.
You know what I mean? And that you can't forget about that. And then there's some more stuff coming too. Apple TV Plus launched, and I don't think anybody really cares about that as much.
I haven't really heard.
I think Apple people are rocking with that because I think they got like a year free if they got like the Apple card or like a new iPhone or something like that.
Apple people are real loyal.
Yeah, they don't play no games with that. But what were your first? You said like you touched on it a little bit, your initial.
Going into Disney Quest?
Yeah. So gummy bears.
Gummy bears.
What else really got you? And what do you think do you think Netflix, you get them 5 years, 6 years, 10 years, or do you think they'll still be around?
I think they're gonna be around.
Okay.
And it could turn into focusing on the stuff that you said, mm-hmm. but for the artsy type mm-hmm. or the, you know, those what do you call them? The independent films mm-hmm. and if they could become champion for the independent.
I think that would be the best bet.
You know?
I think that would be the best bet. And that's just me, because I think right now they're trying to compete. And yeah. they're trying to spend a lot of money, and I think, don't go that route.
It's just like, you as a person, mm-hmm. you can't compete with the next man.
Right.
Especially, with Disney is this monster.
Yes.
That people don't realize how much is theirs. Not even what they touch, how much is theirs.
And that's the case. I knew, but it was seeing it.
Yeah.
I knew, like I said, we've been talking about this for like a year or two now, but it wasn't until, you know, last Tuesday, and I clicked it, and I was like, oh my God.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's seeing it is when you really realize, like, yo, they got everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe this was part of their plan when they bought Fox, you know what I'm saying?
And when they did that, I was like, damn.
And we really haven't even seen a lot of the Fox stuff.
No.
We got The Simpsons. Every episode of Simpsons is on there. Mm-hmm. But like I said, the Deadpool, the old X-Men movies. I believe they're going to hold that for
early.
Yeah. But the X-Men animated series is on there.
Yeah.
And I ran through that. Season 3 of the X-Men animated series, to me, is the reason we got a Marvel Cinematic Universe. They are the only place to do not a live action, but to do the Phoenix Saga correctly.
Right, right. They didn't rework it for people who never heard of it.
They did the Phoenix Saga. They showed Phoenix, the Shi'ar Empire. They went through the story correctly, whereas the movies got it wrong twice.
Yeah. All because they want to make people who never heard of it feel comfortable.
Yeah.
Let them come into
you
it.
You got to introduce the characters. And to me, like, the Phoenix Saga is a trilogy of itself.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You can't fit that in one movie. You know, it's like, that just, no.
They water it down.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time you're done, the people who, I look at it this way, give them the comic book version.
Yes.
People are going to get drawn in. The comic book people will drag in their friends.
Right.
Because you get a movie like any movie, for example. You go into it, you don't know nothing about the characters. You don't know nothing about the backstory.
Right.
You fall into the movie, guns is firing. Welcome.
Right.
You know?
And a good movie will explain
as you go
a lot of stuff, yeah.
So you don't have to, like what they was doing with Spider-Man for a long time. Every movie, how he became Spider-Man. Babies come out knowing who Spider-Man is.
Kids love Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they don't need to be retold.
Right.
Not only do they not need to be retold, they don't need to be retold slightly different.
Right. Yeah.
You know?
Speaking of which, Spider-Man is not on Disney Plus, obviously, because it's still Sony's property.
Please give it up.
I wonder how they're going to... And that's another thing. Sony has yet to announce, like, a streaming service. They got Crackle, but Crackle is kind of like more for older stuff.
Like Crackle.
Yeah, Crackle's cool. Short Circuit was on there.
Yeah.
Like a lot of older movies, but I don't know if Sony's going to really put a lot of money into it now to get into the streaming war. But we're going to need somewhere for Spider-Man to live.
Yeah. I just want them to give him up. Reason why, I understand, you're not going to give up this big moneymaker for you.
Right.
I want them to give it up for the people who want to see Marvel characters done the right way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because, I mean, when we first saw Spider-Man, the movies,
it
was cool. Spider-Man was like, you know,
it
wasn't, we had comic book movies before.
Right.
But, you know, they were rare.
The old Fantastic Four.
Yeah.
And, yeah, it was bad. It was bad.
So, when you see it finally done right, the way Disney is doing it,
yeah,
we need more of that.
Yeah. You know, Spider-Man's still in high school. And that's why kids love him. He's a high school student. And that's, to me, that's why I always gravitate towards Marvel over DC. DC is gods. They're like godlike. Marvel is always, you know, and this could happen in real life.
Yeah.
But Spider-Man more so than, because he's a kid. And as us growing up, reading comics or watching the cartoons, we're like, yeah, he's high school. I'm in high school. I could be like that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that's why kids grabbed, because he was dealing with high school issues.
Yeah, he was.
Mary Jane, Gwen Stacy, like, he got girl problems.
Getting treated like dirt.
You know what I mean? He's struggling. And when he becomes an adult, still he's struggling with a job. He's taking pictures for the Bugle, but he's not paying rent. Like, he always had common man problems.
I want to know how he ain't popped somebody in the mouth. Flash would have been in a body bag.
With great power comes great responsibility.
I'm not that responsible.
That's what his uncle told him, man. He remember what his papa told him. His uncle who raised him told him, with great power comes great responsibility, and you got to be able to be responsible.
I wish they could. It would be nice, because I'm a DC fan too.
And I'm a fan too. Don't get me wrong, but I always gravitated more towards Marvel.
And I liked DC because they always seemed to be darker.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
And just to on topic but off topic. Marvel needs to give DC a little assistance. And this is all they need. Don't try to do us. Because Marvel is more family oriented. Marvel has dark stuff.
Yeah.
But DC, this is your opportunity to go in the dark.
And I think they're doing it now. I think they may have given up on the universe. And they're just doing individual movies.
And that's what they should.
I think that's what they're going to do now. Because the same way Star Wars made trilogies a thing.
Yeah.
Marvel made universes a thing.
Right.
And nobody really got trilogies right. The part threes have always been bad.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at most trilogies in history, Star Wars got it right. I think Return of the Jedi was the last one in that original series.
Right.
It was because it was A New Hope, and Empire Strikes Back, and then Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
That was a ill part three. And they got it right again when they did the other trilogy, when it ended off with Revenge of the Sith.
Yeah.
And that's when Anakin turns into Darth Vader.
And he lost the landing.
Right, but they killed it. Part three stuck the landing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Most trilogies, when you look at, like, Dark Knight Rises, I wasn't really feeling it. I mean, I don't even know which one, what else to count. Like, Godfather 3 really wasn't as good as the other Godfathers. True. Terminator 3 was, like, was it Salvation or was that? They went to, like, 4 or 5. We're not going to talk about Terminator because...
3 was the one with the female Terminator.
Yeah, but T1 and T2 was great.
Yeah.
The third one sucked, and that's why they've been trying to recover from that ever since. So if you look at history... Most trilogies were not good. So Star Wars kind of made the trilogy a thing, and then Marvel made the universe a thing, and everybody's been trying to make a universe, you know what I'm saying? They tried to do the Godzilla universe now, the monster universe. They tried to make a dark universe with, like, the Mummy, and they wanted to do Jekyll and Hyde and Dracula and stuff. That failed off the rip.
Yeah.
DC tried to do their universe, and like you said, they were trying to catch up to Marvel.
Yeah, don't.
Instead of when you had all the property, the one thing that the advantage DC had over Marvel was they had their A-list characters.
Yeah.
You got the Batman, the Superman, the Wonder Woman's. Marvel did it with, you know, Cap and Iron Man and Rocket Raccoons and.
That's what dude I was talking to at work, mm-hmm. and I didn't even realize it. Mm-hmm. He was like, when the whole thing started, Iron Man and all of them.
Yeah.
And as far as comic books go,
yeah.
Those were C-list characters. Yes.
And a lot of people don't realize that.
Yeah.
Like, they didn't have X-Men, Spider-Man. Like, they didn't have... Those were their top...
Yeah.
And the funny thing is, Sony could have owned the whole thing.
And they turned it down.
They turned it down. No, we just want Spider-Man. And it was like, all right, we'll give you Spider-Man. Fox, y'all want X-Men? Okay, hey, like, they was having a yard sale.
Yeah.
Sony could have had the whole thing I forgot what the number was. $2 billion, $4 billion, something like that. It's now each movie... Like, the universe combined, I think they said 23 movies is worth about $40 billion. Something crazy like that. Or, like, let's say a billion a piece, $24
billion. Right.
You know, each movie, because they did, like, high or low, about a billion a piece. $24 billion.
I'm glad they
did. In 10 years?
I'm glad they didn't.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You wouldn't have seen none of it. None of
it. It'd have been a lot of... Because even despite the first Spider-Man series, part one was good, part two was great, part three sucked.
Yeah.
Then they did it again. Part one was okay. Part two, trash. So now that Spider-Man is in Marvel, and if you look at it, like, Captain America's trilogy, it's probably the best trilogy, but they cheated. Part three was Civil War.
Yeah.
That's kind of a cheat code.
Yeah. And Winter Soldier is my favorite overall Marvel movie.
Yeah, I can see. Yeah, I know why you like.
I watched repeatedly.
I can see that.
That was one of the first things I watched when I.
Right. No. Oh yeah, when you put it in Disney Plus, yeah.
Because for me, when Cap's clearing out the ship in the beginning,
The parkour that he's doing, MMA. That's what I said. As soon as I can see why you loved it. Yeah,
he's busting him down. So I mean, Disney is awesome. Disney's freaking awesome. They really are.
So right now you got Disney Plus, you got Netflix, you got Prime, you said Amazon Prime.
And Hulu. Yeah.
Do you see yourself adding more?
No.
Do you see yourself...
This is what's going to happen. I'm going to stay with this for as long as possible.
Okay.
And the reason why is because I haven't had cable other than internet.
Right.
Like,
I haven't had
cable in probably... 6 years or so?
Yeah. I'm at that point, too. I got the basic cable, the high-speed internet, and that's all I need because my apps run everything else.
Right. And, and what happened was, you know when you have a little trial?
Yeah.
Because we had the three thing. We had the
play?
Yeah. And when that bill showed up, I got
it. Right. What's the year, the annual, what do you call the introductory?
Yeah. I looked over at the wife. I was like, look at this. She's like, what happened? Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
And I got it with them.
Yeah.
All I want is internet. Are you sure? Please.
The only thing I really watch live is sports. But the major sports is like ABC, ESPN, TNT for basketball, you know what I'm saying? So I'm good. Right now, like, because the baseball playoffs was on, and I couldn't even see when the Yankees was on MLB Network. I didn't have it.
Right.
And I think I could have got it, but I didn't want to click the button because I didn't want them charging me for it. But I ain't got it. I canceled a bunch of all the extra stuff. I got the most basicest cable right now. The only thing I really watched on cable was Power, and that kind of fell off, but I pretty much download every episode when I want to see it. And then, like I said, now Netflix I had, YouTube I mostly watch, Hulu I got, and then now Disney Plus. And like I said, I'm in the honeymoon phase with Disney Plus, because I'm just like, what am I going to watch tonight?
Yeah.
What am I going to watch tonight? And the only other thing I think I can see myself getting is HBO Max, but they're talking about $14.99.
Yeah, they're getting too close to cable fees.
And that's what I'm saying. And if I do Hulu, I mean, granted, I mean, Hulu I get because my mom has the Sprint account. It's free with the Sprint account. She got the unlimited Sprint plan.
Okay.
So we get Hulu with that. Naya pays for the Netflix. I got the Disney Plus right now. I'm trying to see if you bust down a couple. We go half on that. $6.99. You know, give me three fifty. give me three fifty. But HBO Max talking $14.99, and they gotta have a lot of stuff. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know. Again, seeing the X-Men animated series, every Simpsons episode, I don't know if I'm really gonna watch Hanna-Barbera like that.
But here's the key to me.
Mm-hmm.
How much time do we actually have?
That, which is also true, because I'm actually making content as well. 2021 Vision, website coming soon, app in the future. I'm gonna be out here in these streets too. But I know my levels. I'm not gonna be paying millions of dollars for exclusive content. I'm just gonna create it myself. But yeah, I that's why I haven't, like, sports. I've kind of fell back from watching as much sports. Again, like that's what I said. I haven't really paid for, like, the MLB Network, stuff like that.
Because right.
I'd be recording and I'm editing, stuff like that. So a lot of times I'm watching stuff and it's on in the background while I'm editing or something. I had to watch The Mandalorian, the first episode, about 2-3 times. Because the first time I watched it, I was editing. I watched it again the second time. And I think I was at work or something like that. And then I watched it again. I was like, okay, I'm focused now. I'm paying attention.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of times I'm watching stuff anyway where I'm multitasking. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, the newlywed phase with Disney Plus is because, like, it's so much stuff I could have downloaded. And I don't know if you remember, I lost a hard drive. I had terabytes of stuff that crashed. The hard drive broke. So I had some of the stuff already.
Right.
I had all the Star Wars movies. I had a bunch of stuff already saved on a hard drive that crashed. But now it's in 4K. You know what I mean? I don't have 4K TV, but my phone is like, you know, 4, yeah. You know. But just knowing that they remastered it, they did it. Some people complain about The Simpsons, because The Simpsons is the early episodes is stretched to the 16:9 aspect ratio. Bart's head looked a little wide. But I mean, the early episodes looked weird anyway, because they used different animation.
Yes.
People forget, it was like 20, 30 years ago.
When you go back and look at it, who drew this?
Yeah. So the early episodes looked weird anyway. But looking at, like I said, X-Men, Spider-Man, watching those Tailspin, DuckTales, Darkwing Duck, I was watching Gargoyles the other night. I don't know if I'm going to look at Hanna-Barbera. I think the Jetsons and stuff was before my time.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Like, I need a Jetsons fix. It's crazy because I'll be in the room and I'll be like, I'm going to see some Jetsons.
Right. But the streaming wars has begun. And I mean, we're going to end up spending $100 a month like we do for cable.
Not happening.
Well, you figure if you're giving cable $50-$60 for the internet, and then you're gonna spend $10, $6, $7, $8 here.
We split it.
She married. I need me a wife. I need me a wife to do the. I take Disney Plus. You take Hulu. I take Peacock. You take HBO Max. Like, I need a dual income for the streaming services because. It's getting back up there. Like,
yeah, it really is.
It's getting back up there.
They beating us up real bad.
So and I think there's more coming. Like, so here's the list of, like, services right now. Amazon is $8.99. Apple TV's $4.99. Apple TV Plus, I mean, is $4.99. CBS streaming service $5.99. Disney Plus $6.99. HBO Max $14.99. Hulu $5.99. Hulu TV is $44.99, which I think is like live shows and sports and all that stuff.
Get an antenna.
Basically. Netflix is $12.99. And again, these are the average. It goes up and down depending on which plan you choose.
Yeah.
Peacock to be determined. They haven't released their numbers yet. Showtime streaming service. Streaming service is $10.99. Sling TV $15. Stars $8.99. YouTube TV, which is also live, and they got some exclusive content on there too.
They have this. You say YouTube, right?
Yeah, YouTube TV.
They have this one joint. It's free right now. I don't know if it's gonna stay that way. It's called Impulse.
Mm-hmm.
It's good.
It's a show. It's a show.
It's based off of the movie. Sucked though.
what was the movie?
Jumper. Jumper's actually
Jumper? The one with the dude that played Anakin?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, I didn't realize that's a 3-book series.
Okay.
So, I think it's actually 4, but Impulse is the 3rd book, and it's based on a girl. It's good.
But did they do part 2? What, the third, second book?
Well, they went from Jumper was the movie, was the first book, and the series is off the 3rd, so the second book is...
Okay, come soon.
Okay.
But that's exclusive to YouTube, or...?
It's only on YouTube. But it's not on the paid. Right now, you can view it for free.
Okay, so look up that. Another recommendation from Jay.
It's good.
Impulse.
Impulse.
I think I've seen that, but I didn't know what it was.
Because it started... the first season came out last year.
And that's weird. So it's a series?
Yeah, it's on the second season now.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw a trailer or whatever for the second season.
Mm-hmm.
Then I realized it was first and started watching the first.
Right.
It's good.
I'm shocked they're giving it away for free.
They sucking you in.
That makes sense. It's the drug deal.
Yeah,
give you samples and then like, all right, now you want. But you're saying both seasons, 2 seasons is on there.
But it's not, second season, I believe the second season is released, not weekly, but periodically. So you're not getting the whole bulk.
Mm-hmm.
So they may like get you a hype and then cut you in the middle. Like,
that's a possibility too.
Please subscribe.
Right, right. But, I mean... We'll see where the streaming services go. Everybody listening and watching, let us know what services you plan to purchase, which ones you're looking at. If you plan on doing any of them or none at all. If you're riding out with Netflix and only Netflix, let me know. You know, I've never been a huge fan of Netflix. I'm just gonna be honest. And it's nothing. It's because they really and they couldn't. They didn't make anything. You know what I'm saying? It was never theirs. They were cable kind of. You know, but they were the outlet, and they set the tone for this streaming service thing, kind of.
I mean, then they were where you can get your old seasons.
Right.
That was one thing that I realized. Like, you could, when we have Hulu, you see what's going on now, which is great.
Mm-hmm.
But if you came in on season 3, you got a luck. Right. Unless you had Netflix, and you can run back.
And you can run back. And they killed Blockbuster.
Poor Blockbuster.
They killed Blockbuster, so now they're on the other side of this where they're fighting for survival. And I commend them for not just stick, because that was Blockbuster's downfall. Blockbuster didn't adapt and adjust until it was too late. Netflix is trying to stay afloat. It's just, you know, they're at a disadvantage because they don't have their actual studio.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, I also forgot, BET's doing that, speaking of studios. Tyler Perry has his studio just opened up in Atlanta.
That's what they need to team up
with. You know what I mean? But he's with BET. He's doing a lot. His studio, he uses it because they film Black Panther there. They film like everything there.
Right.
But he himself is doing content for BET. So, you know.
Tyler Perry, make Netflix chocolate.
Netflix chocolate.
I'm saying. I mean, if... He could easily come up with a secondary studio title.
Yeah.
That'll work with them.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got the room.
Yeah, but that's like I said, that's the only thing. Netflix just don't have their own studio. They just like, hey, we'll pay a percentage to get this. Or we'll pay for the exclusivity of it. Or, you know, we'll pay the distribution. And that's what they do. That's the disadvantage that they have. Because Disney makes their own content. They own the companies that are making the content.
Disney's a monster.
Anything else on your mind, Jay?
No, I'm good.
You good?
I'm good.
Thank you for, you know, doing the show.
Thank you for having me, bro.
You gonna do it again?
I'll be back. I'll I'll be back.
And like I tell everybody, whenever something comes up on your mind, you want to talk about it, hit me up. Let me know. We can vent. You know what I mean? I do the podcast. This airs every Wednesday. Shout out to everybody listening and watching. Also do the homie calls. Okay. So you can get on the Skype or the, you know, voice chat or whatever, and we can talk about something. If you want to talk about something right away, like, yo, listen, I just saw this, I got to talk to you about it. Call me up and do the homie calls.
Cool.
You know, I got a lot of content on the channel. Make sure everybody, you know, is listening. Comment below. Like, subscribe, share it with your friends. Don't be stingy. Let everybody else know you like this. You know what I mean? You subscribe, right?
Yeah.
You share
from day one.
You tell anybody about it? You share.
I pop it out when I see it.
You tell your people at work about it? Like,
I don't tell some people at work.
Oh, okay. Well, let's just be watching it and be like lean the phone towards. Oh, this is my brother. This is just, you know, he got a YouTube channel. I'm on there. You know, just let them know.
I circulate.
No doubt. And y'all do the same thing. Everybody that's listening, everybody that's watching, tell your friends about it. You know what I'm
saying?
That's
something we tend to do, though. Try to keep it to ourselves.
Yeah, don't be selfish. I'm not here for everybody. I'm, you know what I mean? Just, you know. And if anybody want to be on, let me know. A couple people hit me up. I'm working on it. Right now is a bad time because of the holidays and stuff. Next year, I'm definitely going to be able to get a schedule and get everybody, you know, planned on it. But right now, I can only get certain people, certain guests, and... You know, like I said, me and John doing the Hands of Time. So the holidays is kind of like I'm doing a yearly wrap up. I'm doing a holiday special maybe while I'm down there with my family. Might do a Christmas special or something, but it's just that. But next year, I'm gonna definitely be able to get some new faces on there, and you know, we gonna have some fun with it next year. And also for the 100th episode, I'm trying to do a live show.
Okay. Yeah.
So you know, what I mean, I'm trying to do a whole, you know, get a stage, do a little, you know, 100th episode. You know, trying to do it big.
Right.
You know what I mean? So tell your friends, we'll sell some tickets.
Cool.
Tell everybody to come through, enjoy the show. I do not have a venue yet. I do not have a date yet, because it also depends on how these episodes go out.
Right.
If I do an episode a week from here on out, it'll be around June.
Okay.
But I also coincides with Mia's graduation.
Right.
So I got to find out when she's graduating as well, so it might get pushed to like July. But we're going to see. Right now, I don't have a date yet, but I will keep everybody posted on that. Venue, time, date, all that stuff will be to be determined. Got some new shows coming next year as well. Got a lot going on the channel. I'm not Disney Plus, but I'm just me. It's, you know, just doing what I can on the budget I got, you know?
You need a blooper reel, dude.
A blooper reel?
You gotta do a blooper reel.
I leave some of the funny stuff in there. I kind of leave some of the comedy stuff in there.
A dirty blooper
reel. Oh, no. I don't have a dirty blooper reel. I do have some stuff that gets cut. You know what I mean? But I don't really have... I keep the... If it's funny, I keep it in there. A couple weeks ago, me, John, and Jared, shout out to the homies, was in Staten Island. And ironically, we were talking about the Wu-Tang Killer Bees. And a bee tried to attack me.
I'm sorry. People think, come on, man, I could die.
I
don't know.
Yeah, man. Yeah. So, I punked up a little bit, but I left it in there. I said I was going to cut it out. I left it in. I said it was funny. I don't have a problem making fun of myself. You know what I mean? If I'm going to share anything, if I'm going to have guests on and we're going to have them expose or see how they feel, I got to do the same myself. So, I can't edit out my vulnerable moments.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I leave it in there. It's me. I you know, I got nothing to hide. I got, you know.
You should do a, and I don't mean to throw, suggestions out there because it's your show.
No doubt. No. I'm open to suggestions.
You know all the stories that you have? Going out, certain people? Need to have a discussion about some of these moments.
So you...
No.
No, you...
I already know you don't. No. It's not about me. It's not about me.
So I gotta say anonymous?
I mean... That it might be for the best.
You have any specific examples you want to give?
I personally know. I don't.
I think you do. We'll talk about it off camera. Jay might be getting a show as well next year. Jay's Tales.
I mean, you know what?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of those stories are fuzzy.
Oh, now you don't remember.
No, but I mean, really think about it.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have everyone who was there,
make some phone calls.
But there's things that would be missing.
Like?
I don't know.
We can figure that out.
It's not necessarily me.
When we call R. Kim right now?
There's stuff that R. Kim did too.
That's what I'm saying. I'll call him right now. We can get some.
Oh, we got it.
Let him call Joaquin right now?
We're running out of time.
No, I got time. It's my channel. I control it.
Run out of time.
CDs. I got a memory card. I can copy this up to the hard drive. What's up?
There's a lot of stuff out there.
Want me to call Joaquin right now?
No.
What up? Shout out to Joaquin. Yeah. You know me, nigga? No?
It's a lot of blurry.
Oh, it's blurry.
Come on, you know a lot of that. There's a good amount of...
I remember some things. I know you remember some things. I think you're right. Right now. We could,
I mean, there's all kinds of stuff.
Uh-huh. But, yeah, so the most fundamental feature of language is that it allows us to exchange thought. In conversation, we connect the private world of our minds to the minds of others. That's deep, right? It's so deep. I'm trying to memorize it. That's how I had to write it down, but it's deep. But the conversation continues. We're going to get Jay to tell some stories. Because he got some, and he's fronting right now.
There's a lot of stuff, man. It's not...
See?
It's not like I'm the star of the stories all the time.
No, but you were there. Yeah. So... We gonna try to get the people that was involved in it, and if not, we're gonna have Jay's Tales.
No, man, well, it's not gonna be me laying it out.
But you can.
We need people to sign off. Some worlds may crumble.
Well, we'll figure it out. But until then, you know, shout out to everybody listening and watching. You are appreciated. And until then, we'll see you next week, alright? Later.